Since murdered a woman because she refused to go out with him to another room. He also showed the pit in which he dumped her dead body. Another soldier says he killed a civilian just because he did not know a code word used by Ukrainian nationalists.
I said to her, let's go to another place nicely, or I'll shoot you dead. She refused. I shot her in the temple. I got a bit scared. I was interested how a person dies.
Two guys came. I asked them to stop. They didn't want to stop. I asked one of them what the word palyanitsa means. He didn't answer, and I shot him dead. The second replied that the word means bread, and I let him go.
Moscow is making extensive efforts to provide civilians in the area with food and other humanitarian aid, as well as evacuate those who want to leave. The Kremlin adds it had to use military vehicles and armored personnel carriers to get out scores of residents, including 14 children, from the city under fire from the Ukrainian army. Locals say Kiev's troops did everything to put civilian lives in danger.
They put mortar launchers in residential buildings. They also started shooting just at residential buildings and districts. It was clear that they were aiming directly at the houses. They didn't care who they were shooting at. On the 20th, Azov soldiers simply started shooting at the house from the tank. People tried to run out. The houses were on fire. They just started shooting at us. Ukrainians also went into basements. They either shot people or drove them onto the street where there were mines. People, of course, were blown up. The Ukrainians also bombed the theater where children were, and they knew it.
Volunteers brought water twice, that's all, nothing more. That is, the Ukrainian side does nothing. Nothing, nothing at all. Under the bombing I drove for drinking water. There is nothing.